thank you, bro.
Hey, wait, can you repeat that again?
I've been to so many gyms in San Diego. I'm almost 50 years old, and this man made me feel like I'm a young guy here with these 20-year-olds. He did his thing, brother. Thank you, coach.
He's milking that time. Boxing
almost 20 years. And when I hooked up with Bomber Squad, they took their time to let me get back into the flow of things. They did the sparring. I just love the sport. I'm not going to compete. Yeah, no. But they allowed me to get back into the sport that I love, to train, to work with me. And when I slack off like I am at an old age with this weight, they get on me. The coaches get on me. I mean, they sit there and call me like, look, man, you need to chill out on your eating. And they work with you. Come in here to mid-work, and I'm halving. They don't have. They make you work. People throwing up and everything. They make you put in the work. Because his mentality is, if you're going to be in this gym, if he's going to train you, you're going to be where you're supposed to be at. You're not going to be coming up in here as a socialized class and not putting in the work. So I'm thankful for what this gym did for an old guy. Like I said, I'm almost 50, man.
You know,
I'm almost 50 years old. And I can come in here and I'm just sparring with these guys. These people 20-something years old. And I'm like, for what they doing, I feel like I compete with the certain guys. There's certain guys around here I don't even get in the ring with. Like Trinell and these guys that's about to go pro, they on another level. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's amazing what they do. But for the guys that's starting in, I get to work with them. I get to, you know, move around with them. And it's wonderful, man. It's wonderful. So, yeah, I had to say that about him. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't know if a lot of people give him his props. But I definitely got to give him his props for what he did for me. You know, so. What's your name again?
My name is Oliver.
Oliver. DC,
so,
man.
DC, nice to meet you, man. So you're about to turn 50 right now. You could be at a nursing home just relaxing.
Man, I got relatives, man, that sit in the house, go to work and eat. And they're 300-400 pounds. You know what I'm saying? I'm getting the weight off me because I'm doing something I love, and these guys motivate me, man. When I see some of these guys in here winning, all these tournaments they winning, you can't come in here and have. Because these dudes put in the work. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I come in here, it's like they motivate me. You got youngsters 8, 9 years old winning tournaments. You know what I'm saying? It's like, okay, I'm in this gym. I got to do something. And it's motivation.
One thing about Bomber Squad as well is that, you know, they teach you boxing, but they also teach you about life outside boxing.
Man. Yeah, let me say this, man. I'm a very competitive person. I tried to come up with a scheme a while ago where I was trying to say, hey, let's do a ranking system. Who were the best in the gyms? And one of the coaches stepped aside and said, man, I don't want to do that because we have a family atmosphere. We all work with each other. We're not out here to hurt each other, but we're going to put in the work. But if we do that, it's going to be so competitive that people are trying to hurt each other. And why do you need to do that? You know what I'm saying? Go against the mother gyms. And here, it's a family-oriented type of atmosphere. They call you. They work with you. I mean, her right here, she developed a eat schedule for me. These two are nutritionists, and they boxers. So it's wonderful, man.
Tell us about your coach, your nutritionist coach.
Oh, man. Rawa, I bugged her, and I wanted a nutritious schedule. And so many people come to her, you know what I'm saying? So she finally made one for me. And when I slack off and I'm not sticking with it, she called me and said, what's going on? I can tell you not sticking with it because you're not dropping the weight that I know you should be dropping with the work you're putting in. So it's like they motivate you, they're family oriented, they care about you. You know what I'm saying? They're just not here to just, okay, we're going to get the pay. You do what you're going to do. That's on you. You know? Oh, they call me like the boxing guru, man, because my boxing knowledge, I'm just, you know what I'm saying? I love boxing. I've loved it for over 40-something years, man. So it's just a wonderful atmosphere, man. Wonderful atmosphere.
All right. Thank you for your time, man.
Thank you, brother. Be safe, brother.
There you have it.
52.1. What's up? What's up?
52.1, we got Coach Rabo here. Tell us about the nutritionist and fitness for DC real quick.
Oh,
no In-N-Out burgers, no.
Yeah, no fast food, no soda, no extra sugar, no none of that. No energy drinks, that means Monster, Red Bull, no crap like that. I had him started on his oatmeal, so an oatmeal with a scoop of peanut butter. And that was his morning breakfast, so sometimes I think he would throw a boiled egg in there, you know, just to, but it fills you up for the morning, and I told him never to eat an hour before he comes, because you would end up by that trash can, would be your best friend, you know. So just to make sure that it digested in, simple stuff, I'm a chicken lover, I grew up with beef, but started aching my body and stuff like that, so I don't recommend it to people if I don't do it. They asked me if they can eat steaks, things like that. I mean, once in a while, I just wouldn't do it all the time. I'm actually going vegan next month,
nice.
So I'm going to see if I can start my story on that. So follow me @ActiveLove_, and follow my journey, and let's see if I can take it more than 5 days this time.
There you go. So you're going vegan next week, right? And then
April 1st.
What's the last meal you're going to eat? The last steak meal or meat meal, anything that you want to just indulge?
My roommate wanted to make me something. She said she makes the best chicken wings.
Chicken, okay.
So I told her I need a batch of 3 different kinds.
Of chicken wings?
Yes.
What about if it doesn't come out pretty good? Then where are you going to go?
I mean, either way, I'm not going to eat chicken for the next month. So I bet.